So good afternoon, everyone. Today we will see the transfer function of field controlled DC servo motor. Now you look at this. This is the equivalent circuit diagram of the DC motor. And this equivalent circuit diagram, you can see here, the field is controlled in this case, and the armature voltage is kept constant. This is not field, this is armature voltage, and this is field voltage. So in the previous class, the field is kept constant, and in today's class, the field is the variable and armature is kept constant. And these are the few terms that we need to look at while deriving a transfer function of field control DC servo motor. RF is the field resistance, LF is the field inductance, IF is the field current, VF is the field voltage, T is the torque developed, and KTF is the torque constant, J is the moment of inertia, and B is the frictional coefficient. And from this field circuit diagram, we can use this equivalent circuit diagram in order to write the equations. So by taking a field equivalent circuit diagram, you can see here only RF and LF are the two elements that involved in this field circuit diagram, and VF is the applied voltage. Apply KVL equation to this equivalent circuit diagram, so we can write the voltage drop across the field resistance plus the voltage drop across a field inductance or inductive field winding must be equal to the applied field voltage. So VF must be equal to IFRF, because IF is the current that is going through this equivalent circuit diagram, and LF into DIF by DT. And we know the torque equation, which is the torque equation is directly proportional to the field current, because the field is variable here, but not the armature. So in our conventional torque equation, which is T is equal to K phi and IA. However, this equation can also be written as K IA IF also. In the place of phi, we can write IF. And IF into IA. K is a constant. In this case, we are keeping IA is also constant. So K and IA, these two terms are constant here. Only IF is variable. So that's why torque is directly proportional to IF. Simply, we can write in place of K into IA, we can write a constant, that is KTF. So T is equal to KTF into IF. So this is our second equation. And in the previous class, we have seen the back EMF equation also. However, the back EMF involves in the armature circuit, not in the field circuit. So you can see here, there is no back EMF. So there will be no comment or no equation of back EMF here. And coming to the mechanical part, we know this is our DC motor mechanical part. And from this part, we can write the mechanical torque equation like this. We have already seen in the previous class, which is armature controlled DC servo motor class, right? So totally, we have got three equations here, only three equations. In the armature controlled, we have four equations, and the fourth equation will be the back EMF equation. Here, there is no back EMF. That's why we have got only three equations. Now, all these three equations are in time domain. Now, we need to convert those time domain equations into Laplace transform domain conversion. So this is the Laplace conversion representation. So we can convert the time domain equations into the Laplace domain equations. So this equation can be written as RF into IF of S. We can see here the I is very small, because a small letter, because this is a time domain representation. Here it is capital I, because this is in Laplace domain representation. So remember, don't do mistakes in the examination. You have to write small letter words for the time domain variables. You have to write capital letters for the Laplace domain variables. Okay, and LF into, here you can see this is first order differentiation. That's why S power 1 will be there here. So S into DIF of, sorry, S into IF of S. equal to Vf of s. So this is our first equation in the Laplace domain, and the torque equation also T of s is equal to KTF into I of s. The second equation, and the third equation also, you can see here, this is d square, so we'll get the s square term here. So j into s square theta of s plus here d by dt, that means we'll get s, which means b into s into theta of s equal to t of s. So these are the three equations, three algebraic equations that can be converted from time domain equations into Laplace equations. And you can see here, this torque equation can be substituted here, right? We need to calculate the transfer function. So transfer function is nothing but the input to the output to the input, which is our motor output is displacement. So the displacement is represented with the theta of s, because this is in Laplace transform. Transfer function must be represented in Laplace transform, right? So theta of s by here, our input is a Vf, a field voltage. So Vf will be our input. So we need to get the transfer function as a theta of s by Vf of s. Remaining this torque, field current, we need to eliminate these terms. So for that, we need to simplify. That's why in the place of torque, I can substitute this term. And similarly, you can see here in these two terms, If is constant. So take If is constant here. So this equation can be written like this, where If is taken as constant. And by combining these two equations, we will get like this. Because in the place of torque, we have written KTF into If of s. However, from this equation, we can eliminate If of s. How? See, write this equation for If of s, bring this constant this side, then we will get this one, where theta of s is common in both the terms. So theta of s is taken out. So js here only, this s is also taken out. See, s is taken out, theta of s is taken out. So that's why here js plus here b by this constant. So this will be our if. However, this if can be substituted here in this equation so that we can eliminate this if value also, or if variable also. So substituting this, we will get this equation. You can see this rf plus lf into s is there, and substituting this if here, s into theta of s is there, and js plus b by constant. Okay, which is equal to Vf of s. We need to get theta of s by Vf of s, because theta is output and Vf of s is the input. So bring this Vf this side and theta in this side. Then we will get this equation. You can say simply this will come under denominator. This is also come under denominator. This KTF goes to numerator because we are shifting the sides. So that means theta of s by V of s, Vf of s is equal to KTF by s into Rf plus s into Lf into B plus Sj. So this is our final transfer function of the field controlled DC servo motor. However, we need to represent the transfer function as a 1 plus s format. So for that purpose, here you can see if I take Rf as common here, so we will get 1 here. So 1 plus s into Lf by Rf will be the term we'll get here. Similarly, here I can take B so that I can also get 1 plus s format. So then the equation will become like this. So in this term, I have taken Rf as common. So in the place of Rf, 1 plus, here there is no Rf, that's why Rf is divided. So Lf by Rf. Here I took B as common. Okay. So this Rf and B, take it to the numerator. So which will become KTF by Rfb. I'm sorry. So KTF by RF into B. So the KTF by RF into B is simply replaced by a term KM. And this KM is nothing but the motor gain constant. And remaining terms are there in the numerator, which is S into 1 plus S into this term. This term is represented as a field time constant, which is TF. TF is nothing but LF by RF. So in the place of LF by RF, simply write TF. So TF is the field time constant. And similarly, TM is the mechanical time constant, which we got the same for the armature controlled DC servo motor also. So TF is the time constant for the field. TM is the mechanical time constant. Okay. So this is how we can derive field controlled transfer function of DC servo motor, which is theta of S by VF of S. So this will be our final transfer function.